This is how to replace the antenna ring for the transporter key. Be sure to disconnect the car battery first, just to be sure to don't have any problems. Lower the steering and pop the upper cover, and then check a little bit this kind of rubber gaskets or whatever trim is. See how they sit in there before you remove them, because sometimes it's pretty annoying to put back. I want to show you behind. It kind of has like this, these guys go horizontal, so it sits like that, and also has kind of holes here. It's a bit weird. And then we need to undo three bolts, T25, and then to remove this cover, you don't need to remove it completely, but you have to pull to flip it over the antenna rig properly after you have removed that rubber piece. So just pull on it gently. This is your antenna ring there. There's a connector here, the green one, and it's only one clip on this side. That's all. You just, with your finger, just undo that clip there, or maybe with a screwdriver. We can also just press here. There's a tiny, tiny tab. Press, but it will feel like it doesn't come out. You just keep pressing there and just wiggle it like this. It does come out, but there's no other clip, no other connector, anything. Basically, you just keep pressing this tiny, tiny tab like that. And of course, disconnect it. There's no programming. I did put a used one on mine. This was my original one, 73073. This one has completely different number, and it did work, plug and play. But remember to have the car battery disconnected, just to be sure, and then put it back in place. Just slide it there and just press it in and just pop in place. Go gently, maybe wiggle it a little bit. It's a little bit weird system. It doesn't want to go in. Oh, try to keep pressed here when you push it in. There's also kind of the camera cannot really film that. Let's see, my vertical. There's also some kind of clip behind it, but if you just go gently, it does feel like it doesn't want to slide in, but just go gently, you won't break, and keep it aligned like this with the clip. Make sure the clip is aligned with that where it's locking. So that's how you remove it. That's how you put it back in place. And so you notice it does, it can't turn like this, but try to align it with that clip there. That's how you engage it and should stay secure. I know sometimes people replace it because and this happens quite a few times, and be really careful with this. Like when you park the car for a while, maybe 1 week or maybe 1 month or so, I will always strongly advise you to disconnect the car battery and make sure you can. I have a video on my channel, perhaps I will link it, how to park the car with the battery disconnected for long term. Make sure you check first the barrel into the door. It works, because you'll have to undo it manually. But what happens is, I've seen quite a few times people say they park the car, and after several days, or depends how good the electrical system is on the car, if there's a power leak or something, after a few days they notice the battery was flat. They eventually open the door, they try to start the car, and they got an immobilizer. I don't remember exact the message, but it's like the car doesn't recognize the key. And that, from what I understand from, I think, Volvo Tech were talking about on forums, it's because DCM may got corrupted. The software on the CM that's recognizing the key chip may got corrupted when the battery went flat and stayed flat like that on several days or several weeks. That's why you don't want to that thing to happen to your car. Always, if you store the car, if you think that it's just too long term, you don't know if there is a battery drain, something, disconnect the battery and check my video. I will link how to store the car. And if you get that immobilizer, whatever message is, I don't know what the fix is. Nobody that had that problem came back on forums to tell us what was the fix, if there's a fix. But I'm guessing you have to tow the car to Volvo and have the CM reprogrammed. There's no problems, nothing has to be replaced, nor the key, nor the CM, nor the antenna ring normally, but there's perhaps a software update that has to be done. Hopefully Volvo can do that. That's just from reading on forums. I never had that problems on my car, but I'm just sharing the information. Thanks for watching. I hope you find this useful. Thanks.